after 1988, we survived. But after 1990 elections, it changed, political situation changed. 1990 election, the military regime miscalculated the situation. They think they will win some parts of the election, so they call ceasefire to all the resistance armed groups to come to negotiate with them. They want to stop fighting each other, and they give many advantages to the ceasefire armed group, business, development, and to keep arms with them, and to control the area you have ever control, to keep your organization still running. So that kind of opportunities are very nice for our leaders in the jungle. Only one thing they're afraid is they have to give up their arms. If they have a chance to keep their own arms, they don't afraid to go anywhere. So when the military regime made that trick, many groups start to go back with negotiate with the regime that time. Our Po'o group also think it is a good opportunity for us to go back and join hands with the military and start developing our area. So they call me, my leaders call me, Ko'oka, please come back. That time I have 60 soldiers on the board and some students in the Manipur school. Altogether, I have about 80 people on the border under my control. They want me to go back, bring back my people and to attend the Po'o convention, Po'o national convention, to discuss on how to deal with the invitation of the regime. But I know that trick, so I insist not to go back. And at the same time, unfortunately, I have a trip to the Germany that time for Barmisat seminar in German, Cologne. When I was there, the situation that inside Burma changed, and my mother party agreed ceasefire with the military regime that time. And I denied that agreement. So I decided not to follow their agreement and just stay away and set up my own organization to represent the people on the borderline, the villagers on the borderline, and most of our community inside Thailand. So I have my Po'o People Liberation Organization set up in 1991. In about October, we declare that we are already set up our new political organization for Po'o in the resistance movement. Because we don't agree with the ceasefire agreement with the regime, we cannot believe them. And that time I called a consultation meeting with the monks community, village community, migrant community, or a really well Po'o community in Thai border. I collect them and I ask them what to do. Please advise us. Do we need to go back and join or something there? Or do we need to wash our hands and just abandon the movement and our looking out for our own business? Or we still need to reorganize ourselves and set up some kind of political organization? The three fiction options. But all the delegation that time strongly support that we need to reorganize one political organization on the border. It needs to represent the Po'o community, and it can be the dignity of the Po'o people on the border. More than 10 years, we survived on the movement as the political organization for the Po'o in the opposition. When 1991, PO Nationalist Group in Sisfaya, my own group. And in 1994, that PO Leftist Group also agreed Sisfaya. So no PO group left in the resistance movement. Only me is now kind of working with the alliance, Kareni, Shang. Only my group have access to this alliance movement.